Even as some crucial evidence in the case related to the murder of a security guard, Chandra Bose, went missing, the police now is suspected to be protecting the controversial businessman Mohammad Nisham, who, remember, is the accused in this controversial Hummer case. Getting us more details is Pradeep with us on the phone line. Now, you know, Pradeep, it all boils down to the fact that what about the Kerala police? Do they really do not know anything about it, or they really want to, you know, be blind to the reality?
Well, it would be very, very hard to believe that the Kerala police does not know about the clothes which were worn by Chandra Bose while he was hit. He was chased and hit by the Hummer, which was being driven by the controversial business tycoon, Mohammad Nisham. Now, we have seen allegations being raised right from the beginning. The police were accused of not recording the statement of the victim while he was battling with his life in the hospital, in spite of the relatives telling us that he was conscious not once but several times, but the police made no attempts to record his statement nor his death statement. Also, there were allegations from inside the police force. There was one team which accused that the former commissioner of police, Jacob Job, was interfering in the investigation, and eventually we saw him being suspended from service for unlawful or illegal intervention in the investigation. On the other side, Jacob Job has alleged that he is aware of certain officers where they had tried to influence the probe by seeking bribes from Mohammad Nisham. So the entire investigating process was ridden with controversies right from the beginning, and there were several allegations that there were several powers, both political and otherwise, trying to shield and protect the accused, Mohammad Nisham, who was responsible for this gruesome, brutal murder. Now it boils down to the situation where we have no clue about where the crucial piece of evidence, the dress which was worn by the victim when he was run down by the Hummer driven by Mohammad Nisham.